وَاجْتِنَافُ نَوَاهِيهِ And whatever the Prophet ﷺ has made things forbidden for us, we should stop. And we should not go after those things. وَالتَّعَدُّبْ بِعَذَابِهِ فِي عُسْرِهِ وَيُسْرِهِ وَمَنْشَتِهِ وَمَكْرَهِهِ Beautiful words in Arabic. وَالتَّعَدُّبْ بِعَذَابِهِ Taking all the etiquettes, the manners that Rasulullah ﷺ he taught us. Whether we are in the situation of easiness, we are in the situation of happiness, we are, you know, comfortable in our lives, or we are sometimes in the situation of adversity, that the circumstances are not favorable and we are going through difficult and hardship time, but still we should not leave the etiquettes and the manners of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wa manshatihi wa makrahi. Manshat and makrah, also these two words, manshat when you are happy, makrah when you do not like the things, the way they are going. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي And then he brought and he quoted the ayat of the Quran that I just recited in Surah, in Salatul Isha today, also in the first rak'ah. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي Oh my Habib, oh my beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, tell them, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ If you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you are having this belief, this aqidah, and this commitment, this resolve that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so how can you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? فَاتَّبِعُونِي Follow me. When you follow me, then this is the real meaning of the love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the reward, what will be the reward? يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in return of your love, Allah will love you. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ And he will forgive all your sins. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ So that is number one. Number two, Al-Isar. And subhanallah, I was so much amazed that how Qadi Iyad, he brought right after that topic, this topic of Isar. And Isar, by the way, is something is very unique to Islamic culture, Islamic tradition. We do not find this type of quality in other culture, in the people, especially in the Western culture. Western culture is totally different from that. Now, what is the Isar? Isar means sacrificing yourself for the sake of others. You want to give the benefit to your other Muslim brothers, Muslim sisters, to your community, to all human beings, and at the same time you need that thing and the other brother, he also in need of that thing. So you are not keeping that thing for yourself, but you are sacrificing your own need, your own desire for that thing, and you are giving it to your Muslim brother and to your Muslim sister. Or in other words, you are giving preference to other people than on yourselves. This is the meaning of Isar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran, and he mentioned in the background when he was admiring those Muslim people, those Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in. And I will give you a very brief example, because the whole ayat of the Quran, this is from Surah Al-Hashr. Surah Al-Hashr, very famous surah, ayat number 9. It talks about the people of Medina. You remember that when the Muslim people, they migrated from Mecca and they came to Medina, what was the level of the sacrifice of the people of Medina, the Ansar, the helpers, the local resident of Medina? They welcomed, not only they welcomed the people of Mecca, but they said that from today you will stay in our own houses, in my home, and half of my home will be yours, and I will keep with my family in the rest of my home. And this is my business. From tomorrow you will go with me to the market. You are my partner without any investment. All the capital, all investment is mine. But you will be my brother and my partner in my business. Half of the profit of the business is yours, and half of the business and profit is mine. Subhanallah. The whole world cannot bring this type of isar, this type of sacrifice that the people of Medina, they have shown to the people of Makkah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admired them in Surah Al-Hashr, and He said, وَالَّذِينَ تَبَوَّأُوا الدَّارَ وَالْإِيمَانَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. This is regarding the people of Medina, that they made their homes in the Medina, meaning they were the local resident of Medina. وَالْإِيمَانَ, and they have accepted Iman also. مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ, before the Hijrah, before the migration of the Prophet ﷺ and the other Sahaba, they already became Muslim, as you know from the history, that the people of Medina, they came to Makkah for the Hajj time, and they took the bay'ah, the pledge of allegiance on the Iman and faith, and they became Muslim. So, min qablihim, before the migration, yuhibbuna man hajara ilayhim, they love all those Muslims who are migrating to them. Wala yajiduna fi sudurihim hajatan mimma utu, and they are not finding anything in their heart, kind of jealousy or grudge towards the other Muslim people, if they are having the in'amat or the gift. What was happening, that when there was a distribution of the gifts, most of the time the Prophet ﷺ, he gave these gifts to new Muslims, those who are the new Muslims, in order to make them more inclined to Islam. And he gave sometimes Muhajirin also, because Muhajirin, the sacrifice of Muhajirin is also very great. When they moved, they migrated from Makkah, they left everything behind. They did not bring their businesses with them. They did not bring their houses with them. They did not bring any bank balance or any cash or anything with them. They left everything over there. So in Medina, whenever Rasulullah ﷺ got an opportunity, he gave and tried to compensate whatever they lost back in Makkah over in Medina. So it was another sacrifice of the people of Medina, that they also had the share in those gifts, in those bounties. But they were looking that my other Muslim brother, he was awarded and he was given, I am not given. So because of that, they did not have any jealousy in their hearts. وَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي صُدُورِهِمْ حَاجَةً مِمَّا هُدُوا وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ, and they are making إِسَار. This is إِسَار. وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَسَاسَةً, even though sometimes the people of Medina are also poor, they are going through the poverty. It was not the matter that each and every Muslim of Medina was wealthy person or rich person. They also need this money. And especially, let me tell you this story and I will conclude it, because this is very interesting topic. I would like to continue. There are few points, and not only this one, but I will continue inshallah next week. What is the sabab al-nuzul, shani nuzul of this ayah? That one day Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he announced in the evening prayer, like Isha prayer, that I have some guest and he is my guest, but I do not have any food or anything to feed him tonight in my home. Subhanallah. Messenger of Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said that I do not have anything in my home to feed my guest. Who is ready to take my guest with him? So one sahabi from the Medina Ansari, he stood up and he said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I am here, I will take your guest to my home, he will be my guest. So the Prophet said, okay, go ahead, proceed, take him to your home. Now when he reached home, he told his wife that this is the matter, that I brought the guest of the Prophet. And as soon as she heard, she made like this, you know, gesture. Oh my God, what did you do that? Why did you do that? Said what? He said, today is just like a same situation in our home as well. We have very little food, and that is only sufficient for our kids. And kids, our children, they were waiting for you. When the dad will come home, then we all will eat together. But we planned that me and you will be hungry and we will feed all this food to the kids. And we do not have anything for ourselves. Whatever we have is only for the children. So what should we do? How can we feed the guest now? So this sahabi, he thought, And look, this was the point of the sacrifice. He gave an advice, an idea to his wife. He said, you know what, try to make the kids that they should fall asleep. Just tell them some stories, talk to them or something. Just give them some, things that the food is getting ready, you will get it. And in the meantime, their kids, they are tired, they will sleep hungry. Now, when you will bring the food, so she said, still there is the food only enough for one adult. It's not enough for both of you. He said that when we are about to start the food, you just come inside the room, the area where we are sitting, and say that I would like to fix the lamp. And pretend that you are fixing, but what you should do, that you should put off the lamp. So it will be total dark. And I will say, what are you doing? What did you do? And try to fix it quick, as soon as possible. I will keep saying that, and you just leave. It will be total dark, and I will pretend that I am also eating. You know, I will raise my hand, making the bites, but I will not eat anything. And I will try that my guest and the guest of Rasulullah, he will complete, consume the food, and then in this way, he will eat it to the satisfaction of his, hunger. So she also cooperated. Now, this is a sacrifice of both, the whole family, the entire family, the wife also, subhanallah. And everything was went well according to the plan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about this whole story through the revelation, through the wahi. And when the sahabi, he came next morning in the Fajr prayer, so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he already knew about that, what happened. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayat in Surah Al-Hashr. وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. The whole ayah, and there is the part, وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةً. So that was the love. So this isar is also the sign why you are doing, why you are supposed to do it, because you love the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this isar is the sign, is the alamat of the muhabbat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all these good characters, good qualities, inculcate all these qualities into my personality and into all of you and into all of our Muslim brothers and sisters. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khair khalqihi sayyidina wa nabiyyina Muhammadin wa alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Bi rahmatika ya Rahman. Yes.